Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. This is the new Mercedes GLA and it's in line with the new Mercedes design language. Looks really nice, but this is the AMG line, but the one which is going to be launched will obviously get regular variants too. Now looking at the headlights, obviously it gets a projector beam. It says LED high performance. Obviously it doesn't get the multi-beam lights because this is no AMG, but it says Mercedes-Benz on the side. The way they brand their lights is super cool indeed. Okay, there is not a front parking camera. This is a front parking sensor, I believe. But you can fit the front parking camera in certain variants here. Not in the Indian market though. Again, the parking sensors. The diamond studded grille is very nice. I actually counted it. It's 302. I'm kidding. In the A-Class, it was 302. I'm not pretty sure of how many studs are there on this particular vehicle. Now, because this is the AMG line, the wheels will be slightly more adventurous as such. So 235, 15, 19s. And Mercedes-Benz written on the brake calipers. The disc size is also nice. And obviously, you get a light here, the sort of puddle light in the night is going to project Mercedes-Benz because almost every manufacturer is doing it right now. Okay, from the side, yes, it is similar to the old GLA in terms of size as such. But who cares? Because obviously they've engineered it better now, which means there'll be a lot more space on the inside. Now, this might remind you of the GLC to a certain extent. It's 4MATIC because power is channeled to all wheels, but you know, power will obviously be a little bit more front biased in this vehicle. We've got twin exhaust. How many of them are functional? My guess is as good as yours. Let's open the boot of the new GLA. Okay, the new Mercedes lineup for the entry level cars means A-Class, that one, GLA. I don't know what's going to happen about the A-Class hatchback and the B-Class and the CLA. But hey, it seems that, you know, ek teer do nishana. Oh my God, it's super dark. So no spare wheel on the car, but there is a water bottle somehow. I have to manually close this. Of course, there's a lot of effort involved in this. So there, we shut it. Okay, actually it's getting hydraulically actuated, but it's a Mercedes. So you have to have the fake diffuser. Who does this design language? I don't know. It's not needed for sure. Anyways, coming to the side, on the other side, the design looks really nice. The car looks super fresh as well, but the interior is amazing. You know why? Because Mercedes-Benz is doing this beautiful new instrument cluster along with the center screen. Both of them seem like a one piece. Space at the rear seems decent. You've got this red stitching as well. Red stitching looks really nice as well. In fact, the treatment here is super good and super awesome indeed. And overall, yes, rear seat is a lot more practical than before. You've got this beautiful red stitching on offer. Meanwhile, Mercedes-Benz is actually written on the rear tail light as well on the side. And the lights have a lot of attention to detail. GLA 220D, this is the variant of the car we are walking around right now. And it's going to be priced around rupees, I believe, somewhere around 40 lakhs, which will actually make it quite attractive in the segment, wherein it competes with the BMW X1 as well as the Audi Q3. The new Q3 is expected via the CBU route with a petrol engine only. That light bar is massive on the inside. Look at that light bar. That's something I've never seen in a car. So bright. Wow, Mercedes-Benz written right there. And these are the controls for the headlights. The interior looks nice. What I particularly love about the car is the fact that these screens are super cool. Okay, they've got these dual screens. Yeah, dual screens, one and two. And you got the touchpad, you got the MBUX system. The controls are super awesome for the air conditioning. And this happens to be for the AC vents. So we have got three AC vents. And now when we turned on the vehicle, rather on ignition, you see the dials are super nice and cool. It's something which is very different from what we've seen in Mercedes cars earlier on. And of course, this system, like this, yeah, this particular BlackBerry style touch is super awesome as well. So you got digital display in the center with obviously speedometer on the left and the tachometer on the right and plenty of telltale lights as well. Interior looks really nice and rad. And we got a sunroof too. Meanwhile, oh my God, the co-driver also gets electric adjust along with memory functions. You can save up to 3 people settings for the driver as well, ambient lighting and whatnot. This Mercedes GLA is going to put the segment on fire. It looks so good and it's practical as well because there's good amount of storage space on offer too. It obviously gets the MBUX system. Really, you want to hear that? Hi, Mercedes. Come on, respond. Don't make a popot right now. Hello, Mercedes. Hey, Mercedes. See, she's not interested to talk to me right now. That's really rude of you. This is how you treat your guests. Jokes aside, glove box. Okay, it has a compartment on the upper side too. Love the treatment, love the quality, and everything in the vehicle really speaks of something with great attention to design and detail as well. So guys, this is the new Mercedes GLA, and after a real long time, the GLA has been updated for the Indian market, making it very competitive in front of the BMW X1 as well as the Audi Q3, which is so old right now that it really needs a shot in the arm. So guys, if you like this video, you know what you have to do. Give it a thumbs up, that's a like button, and also subscribe to the channel. I will do a quick walk around of the Mercedes stall right now so that you guys can see more of what's on offer from the biggest luxury car maker in the Indian market from Germany. Bye bye, take care, see ya.